अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल बी सॉल्विंग कैम्ब्रिज IGCSE फिजिक्स पेपर 2 वेरिएंट 22 ऑफ फरवरी मार्च 2023। ऑल्सो ए क्विक रिमाइंडर दैट ऑल ऑफ द रेवेन्यू जनरेटेड फ्रॉम दिस वीडियोस विल गो टू द एड ऑफ अ पैलेस्टीनियन ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, सो प्लीज सपोर्ट अस। क्वेश्चन 1, व्हिच लिस्ट कंटेन्स टू स्केलर क्वांटिटीज एंड टू वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज। सो बाय डेफिनेशन वी नो that scalar quantities are those which only have a magnitude, whereas vector quantities have both a magnitude and a direction. So looking at option A, we have distance, speed, time, velocity. So distance, speed and time, three of these are scalar quantities, so obviously A cannot be correct. Part B, we have force and velocity as our vector quantities and distance and mass as scalar quantities. So this fulfills the criteria. So B is the correct answer. Question 2, the diagram shows the speed time graph for a car. Which row describes the motion of the car at point X and at point Y? So at point X we can see that the speed is increasing, changing. We have changing speed at point X and constant speed at point Y. So which of the options in the table satisfy this? That is option D only. Point X, it is moving with changing speed. Point Y, it is moving with a constant speed. Question 3. Four objects are moving in a straight line. The table shows the distances moved by each object in each second of its motion. Which object is moving with constant non-zero acceleration? Here the keywords are constant and non-zero acceleration. So the acceleration must be non-zero and it must also be constant. So option A, we have 5, 5, 5, which means that there is no acceleration. Option B, we have 1 meter change per second. So this is accelerating as well as constant. Option C, we have, yes, this is accelerating, but not at a constant rate. The difference between this is not constant. Similarly, in option D, it is increasing, but not at a constant rate. Since the difference between these numbers is not constant. So the correct option is option B. Question 4. The drag force in the car increases with speed. At 20 meters per second, the total drag force is 400 newtons. The mass of the car is 1200 kilograms and the driving force is constant at 700 newtons. Which statement about the acceleration of the car at 20 meters per second is correct? So here we will use the formula F is equals to ma, where F is our resultant force, M is our mass, A is the acceleration. So we know the resultant force would be 700 minus 400, because 700 is in the forward direction, which is the driving force. And drag force, remember, drag force is always against the motion. Drag force will be in the opposite direction. So then we will get the resultant force by subtracting these two forces. So we will get 300. The mass we know is 1200. And you have to find the acceleration. So here we get acceleration as 0.25. So it is either option A or option B. The correct option is option A, because the question says that the drag force on a car increases with speed. So that means the motion against the driving force increases. The force against the driving force increases. That means that the acceleration will decrease, because the opposing force increases with time. Question 5. A rectangular swimming pool is 50 meters long, 25 meters wide. The rest of the information is also given, and they want us to find the mass of the water. So we will use the formula density equals to mass upon volume. We are given the density 1000, mass we have to calculate, and volume we can calculate using the formula length into breadth into height. So we are given all three, 50 times 25 times 2. When you put this in the calculator, you will get mass as 2.5 million kilograms. Question 6. An object is rising vertically at constant speed through water. There are three vertical forces acting on it, the weight W, the drag force D, and the upward force U. Which diagram shows the magnitude and direction of the vertical forces acting on the object? So since it is rising at a constant speed, we know that the forces in the upward direction should be equal to the forces in the downwards direction. So when you look at the options, you can see that only option A and option D satisfy this condition. However, option A, drag force has been shown as moving upwards. So we know that this is incorrect, since drag force is always against the motion. And since an object is rising upwards, we know that the drag force must be downwards. So hence, the correct option is option D. Question 7. Two balls of equal weight sit on the one side of a seesaw as shown. Their father of 8000 newtons sits on the other side. The seesaw is balanced and is being used so that it moves up and down. So the rest of the information is also given. Here we will use the concept of conservation of momentum. So we know that the left side must be equal to the right side since the seesaw is balanced. They have told us that the seesaw is balanced. So using the formula that we know, left side must be equal to the right side. So the momentum of the left side is 1000 times the distance moved, which is 40. And on the right side, if we take the weight of the balls as x, they both have the same weight. So we get 20x plus 80x. So when we solve this for x, we get x as 400 newtons. So option B is correct. Question 8. A student measures the length of a spring. She then attaches different weights to the spring. She measures the length of the spring for each weight. The table shows her results. What is the extension of the spring with a weight of 3 newtons attached to it? So we know that the unextended length was 520. And when 3 newtons were attached to it, the length was 533. When we subtract these two, we get 13, which is our answer. The momentum of a body is changed by a force acting on it for a period of time. Which action increases the change in momentum? So we know that momentum is directly proportional to force. So if we increase the force, we increase the momentum. So by that logic, options C and D are incorrect because we are having the forces in it. So when we look at option A, it says doubling the force and halving the time. So halving the time will have the opposite effect of doubling the force. So basically it will have no change. So option B is correct. Since we double the force for the same time, the change in momentum increases. Question 10. The equation used to find the change in gravitational potential energy of an object can be written as the following. We know the formula is mgh. So they have already given us h. They are asking us for y and z. So looking at this formula, we know that y and z is mass and gravitational field strength, which is option A. Question 11. A machine has a power input of 200 watts and a useful output energy of 1 kilojoules in 6 minutes. What is the efficiency of the machine? So we know the formula of efficiency. It is useful output. I will write this as out upon useful input in 200. So they have told us the input, which is 200. Output we will have to calculate. So the output power we will get through using this two information. Energy is equal to power into time. Energy they have told us 1 kilojoule, which is 1000. And here it is important to convert minutes into seconds, since the SI unit of time is seconds. So 6 into 60, you will get power from here. So putting this into your calculator, you will get 2.7 as your output power. Put this into this formula and then you calculate this, the answer is 1.4%. Question 12. What is the unit of power? Very simple. We know that the unit of power is what? 13. The diagram shows a rectangular block of weight 16 newtons. It is resting on a flat surface. What is the pressure at the base of the block due to its weight? We know that the formula for pressure is equal to force upon area. They have given us the force area of the base would be this 4 times 5. Put this in the calculator and you get the answer as C, 0.8 newtons per centimeter square. Question 14. An oil tank has a base of area 2.5 meters squared and is filled with oil to a depth of 1.2 meters. The density of the oil is 800 kgs per meter cube. What is the force exerted on the base of the tank due to the oil? So we can use the formula density is equals to mass upon volume here. We are given the density as 8000. If we can calculate the mass, we'll be able to calculate the force as well. Volume we know would be 2.5 times 1.2. So when we put this in the calculator, we get the mass as 240 kg, and when we convert it into the force, we will get as 24,000 newtons. Okay, moving on. A sample of gas is trapped in a rigid container. As the temperature of the gas is increased, the pressure increases. Which statement is not correct? The gas molecules have greater kinetic energy. Well, this is true. The gas molecules hit the wall of the container harder. This is also true. Since greater energy, greater speed, they will hit the walls harder. Option C says the gas molecules hit the walls of the container more frequently. This is also true. Option D says the gas molecules move further apart. This is incorrect. Question 16. What happens when the temperature of a liquid increases? So we know that temperature has nothing to do with mass, so options A and B automatically are incorrect. Option C says the volume of the liquid increases, making the liquid less dense. This is true, since when you increase the temperature, the speed of the molecules increase and the distances between the water particles increase, so obviously the volume increases and it makes the liquid less dense. 17. A bar of metal which is a good thermal conductor is heated at one end. What is the main method of transfer of thermal energy along the bar? So we know that metals have free electrons, and any type of transfer of thermal energy or electrical energy in metal occurs through electrons. So C is our correct answer. 18. A transverse wave moves along a rope. The diagram shows the position of the rope at one particular time. Which two labeled points are one wavelength apart? So we know one wavelength is when a wave undergoes one complete oscillation. So the only correct option here is from X to Z, as we can clearly see. So C is your correct answer. Question 19. Light in transparent plastic meets a boundary with air. Light is transmitted into the air only if the angle marked theta in the diagram is greater than 36 degrees. What is the refractive index? So we know that the formula of refractive index is 1 over sine C, where C is your critical angle. So the critical angle is this one, and they've told us that this angle is 36. So we can calculate the other angle, 90 minus 36, we get 54. And when you put this in your calculator, you will get the answer as 1.2. 20. A thin converging lens has a focal length f. An object O is placed to the left of the lens as shown. Where is the image formed and how does its size compare to the object? So here we will make a ray diagram. This is how a diagram is made. Wait a second. One goes through the center of the lens. These two are parallel, so they will meet somewhere over here. This will be your image. So we can see that the image is on the same side of the lens as the object, and it is larger than the object. So the correct option here is C. Question 21. Which diagram shows what happens when a ray of light, white light, passes through a prism? So we know that the white light will refract and speed will also decrease. So the only correct option showing this change is option D. 22. A TV station transmits a signal to a TV receiving dish. The television has an on and off indicator light. The television is switched on by a remote control which changes the indicator light from red to green. Which electromagnetic wave used in these actions has the longest wavelength? Well, we know that the longest wavelength is of radio waves. So which of these options is using radio waves? We can clearly see that this is option A. Option C and D is light waves, and option B is some other wave. So the correct option is obviously option A. 23. A student makes a list of some applications of waves. Medical scanning of soft tissue, sterilizing water, using sonar to calculate ocean depths. Which applications use ultrasound waves? Well, we know that 1 and 3 only uses ultrasound waves. 2 is done by gamma rays. You should know that. So the correct answer would be 1 and 3, which is option C. The diagram shows a ball magnet at rest on a smooth horizontal surface. A length of soft iron wire is held parallel to the magnet. The wire is released. What happens? So we know since both of these are magnetic materials, they will obviously attract. They will get attracted to each other. So the wire will move towards the magnet. Option B. 25. Which diagram shows the electric field pattern and direction around a positive point charge? So we know that the electric field patterns are radially either inwards or outwards. So C and D are obviously incorrect. And you should be able to recall that around a positive point charge, the electric field patterns move away. So A is our correct answer. B would have been for a negative point charge. But here we are talking about a positive point charge, so option A is correct. 26. A laboratory has a standard wire of known resistance. It also has other wires made from the same material as the standard wire, but of different lengths and diameters. Which wire would definitely have a resistance of less than the standard wire? So we know the formula for resistance is resistivity times length over area. So we can see that resistance and length are directly proportional. So since we want lesser resistance, we will also want smaller length. So it will either be C or D. And since we want lesser resistance, we will want greater area, since area and resistance are inversely proportional. So we will have greater area how? When the diameter is larger. So our option, the correct option would be C. 27. The graph shows the relationship between the current in a circuit component and the potential difference across it. The graph has a straight section and a curved section. What happens to the resistance of the component in these two sections as the current increases? Well, in the straight section, when it is straight, the current and PD are increasing at the same rate. So this will have no effect on the resistance. However, when the current decreases, the resistance will increase, since we know the formula is V is equals to IR. And if we solve for R, we have V upon I is equals to R. Here we can see that resistance and current are inversely proportional. So when the current decreases, the resistance will increase. So the option is D. 28. The diagram shows part of a circuit. What is the combined resistance of the resistors? So we know the formula of resistors connected in parallel is 1 over RT is equals to, so here the total resistance would be 3, since these two are connected in series, and this will be 4. 1 over 3 plus 1 over 4. When you solve this, you will get 1 over RT as 7 over 12. When you solve for RT, you will get your answer as 1.7. 29. The diagram shows a circuit which includes two resistors and a battery. The voltmeter reads 6 volts. What is the potential difference across the 30 ohm resistor? So we know we have this formula V is equals to IR. We know that voltage is directly proportional to resistance. So If you increase the resistance, you will get greater voltage. So at 10, we have 6. So how much would we have at 30? When you solve for X, you will get your answer as 18 volts. Question 30. A wire is moved down a direction perpendicular to the magnetic field. Three changes are suggested. The speed of the movement of the wire is increased. The magnetic field strength is decreased. The direction of the magnetic field is reversed. Which changes increase the electromotive force induced in the wire? So we know that the speed of the movement of the wire is increased. So this will increase the electromotive force. So one is correct. The magnetic field strength is decrease. So this will decrease the electromotive force, not increase it. So this was incorrect. And the direction of the magnetic field is reversed. So reversing the direction will have no change on the EMF induced. So only one is correct, which is option B. 31. A wire is moved across a magnetic field. This causes an induced current in the wire. The induced current interacts with the magnetic field to produce a force on the wire. In which direction is this force? So we know through Lenz's law that the direction of the force is opposite to the movement. So only option D is suggesting this, so option D is correct. 32. A 100% efficient step down transformer has primary voltage VP and IP current. Which row compares the secondary voltage with VP and the secondary current with IP? So we know that a step down transformer, it decreases the voltage, secondary voltage, and we also know that since it is 100% efficient, so this formula will hold. The primary voltage and the primary current should be equal to the secondary voltage and the secondary current. So when will this be possible? When the secondary voltage is lesser than VP and the secondary current is greater than IP. So option C. 33. The scattering of alpha particles by a thin metal foil supports the nuclear model of an atom. Why are alpha particles used rather than neutrons? So we know that neutrons are neutral and alpha particles are positively charged. So obviously if we had used neutrons, it would bring about no deflection because it was neutral. And since alpha particles are positively charged, so it would obviously produce a deflection, which was essential for the experiment. So option D is correct because alpha particles have a positive charge. 34. An iron nuclide is represented by the symbol shown. Which statements about the nucleus of this iron nuclide are correct? So looking at this, we know that the proton number is 26. The neutron number would be 30. So the nucleus contains 56 neutrons, that is not true. The nucleon number is 30, that is also not true. The proton number is 26, only this is true. So D is a correct answer. 35. A sample of a radioactive isotope has an initial rate of emission of 128 counts per minute and a half-life of 4 days. How long will it take for the rate of emission to fall to 32 counts per minute? So we know that after 4 days the emissions will halve. So half of 128 we have 64. So after 4 days we have 64 and after another 4 days we will have 32. So 4 plus 4 we get 8 days. So 8 is a correct answer. Several scientists are working in a laboratory. The scientists are experimenting with sources which emit ionizing radiation. Each scientist is given a list of safety rules. Three of the rules are shown. Keep at least 2 minutes away from other people. Well, this has no effect on us, so this is incorrect. Do not stay longer than 4 hours per day in a laboratory. This is true because this will decrease the amount of exposure you are getting. And 3 says stay behind the lead line screen, which is also a correct precaution. So looking at this, we have option D as the correct answer. 37. Which data is needed to calculate the average orbital speed of a satellite around a planet? So we know the formula for the orbital speed is 2 pi r over t, where r is the distance of the satellite from the center of the planet and T is the time for the satellite to orbit the planet. So we need these two information. So looking in this table, option B is correct. 38. Approximately how long does it take for the moon to make one complete orbit of the earth? Well, this is easy. We know that it takes approximately 1 month. 39. The energy generated in stable stars comes from nuclear reactions. Which type of reaction occurs in the sun? Well, you should know that only nuclear fusion occurs in the sun. So options A and C cannot be correct. So looking at option B or D, we have helium nuclei joined together to form hydrogen nuclei, which is not possible because helium nuclei are larger than hydrogen nuclei. So hence D is correct. Hydrogen nuclei joined together to form helium nuclei. So the last question in this paper, two quantities define the Hubble constant, H naught. The speed at which the galaxy is moving away from the Earth, the distance of the galaxy from the Earth. So you should be able to recall the formula, which is V is equals to H naught times D. So looking at this formula, we can see that V is proportional to D, and you should be able to recall the Hubble constant, which is 2.2 into 10 to the power minus 18. So the correct answer is option A. So that's it for this video. I hope you liked it, and if you do, please like and subscribe to our channel, and I will see you later.